Let's hear a round of applause for our wonderful panelists here. We have Ms. Anushree Saxena from Dell Technologies. I'd like to request you all to please stay for a group photograph as I take a moment and thank you all. Once again, let's hear it up for Mr. Nishant Pradhan from Mirae Asset Global Investments, Mr. Bhavesh Chauhan from Galaxy Office Automation, Mr. Tanuj Bhojwani from Ekstep Foundation, Mr. Vikas Trivedi from Ericsson, and of course, our wonderful moderator, Mr. Ram Shashadri from KPMG India. Thank you so very much, each of you all, for your presence here. I think you added so much more to the discussion. I wish we had more time for questions, but I promise you, they'll be joining us for lunch, and you're all welcome to sort of engage with them and take these conversations forward. Up next, we have a very interesting trilogue. Our trilogue is really going to focus on artificial intelligence and our world. It's going to be time to rethink, to reimagine, and revolutionize. Understanding the interconnections between AI technologies, infrastructure, and humans to create a more adaptive AI-driven enterprise. To share a lot more on this segment with us, may I present to you our speakers. Let's hear a round of applause for Mr. Dhruv Chopra, co-founder and chief marketing officer at Chalo Bus. A round of applause, requesting you all to take a seat as per the images on the backdrop. May I please present to you Mr. Yash Tharwadi, founder and CEO at Solsay Energy. Thank you so much for your presence. And to moderate this segment, may I welcome Professor Dr. Charu Malhotra, Coordinator, Center for E-Governance at Indian Institute of Public Administration. Thank you so very much, ma'am, for joining us. It's such a pleasure to have you here. Requesting you all to please take a seat as we kickstart this trilogue.
Okay, so namaskar all of you. When the previous moderator announced that I know I'm holding you up for lunch, I said, what happened to my session? So please don't leave us in between, just matter of 15 minutes and some candid discussions. And thanks ETH for putting us together, not just the wonderful audience with us, but my wonderful panelists with me. As she said, I'm Professor Charu. I've come all the way from Delhi to talk about how startups are feeling in India and how did they come up with these new ideas? How come they are so risk averse? And to do so, why did they repose this trust on me? Because I come with 35 years of experience working with government, working with senior government officers as a professor in digital technology, cyber tech spaces, cyber security, as well as policy making, and been with the same institute for all this period. Okay, so without much ado, I would request in no particular order, but probably Yash being the youngest, let's give him a chance. Yash, how did it all start? And for you, please, you can see, Yash is making something very innovative in terms of providing us solar energy through technology. Over to you, Yash.
Hi.
2 minutes.
Hi guys, I'm Yash Tharwadi, founder and CEO of Solance Energy. Solance is a platform of the all the solar needs. It's a one-stop solution. So what we are trying to do is making a whole solar journey digitalized and also using the machine learning and artificial to use in the preventive maintenance as well as the increasing the production of the solar panels itself. So like solar panels have a 32 component and all the 32 components are from the different brands and different kind of categories. So we have developing a models where the all the 32 components can be optimized as per their efficiency. Secondly, solar is a thing that comes with a latitude and longitude. So everybody in India is live in a different city. So as per your city, your perfect longitude latitude will be different. And as per you know that like sun changes their direction in January, like Makar Sankranti, what we celebrate as. So optimum angle for the solar panel production, that also can be given by the technology. So what we are trying to do is anybody who want to go solar with help of this technology and this application, they just need to download the application and in the 5 simple step, they can go solar and they can get 30% return on investment every year. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you. That was very quick. Dhruv, how did Chalo happen?
First of all, do any of you even know what Chalo is? That's, you do 2, 3, 4, 5.
That's
great.
Talks about.
Yeah. Right. Chalo is an app with which you can live track your buses. Those of you who live in Mumbai, you can use it to live track your BEST buses. when I say life track your buses, for you as consumers, it fundamentally means that you never have to go and wait at a bus stop ever again, right? You can literally go 1 minute before the bus arrives. That's the advantage that daily bus travelers get with an app like Chalo. I was working prior to this in a company called Carvale.com. I think most of you, so more people have heard of Carvale than of Chalo, which is, I think, for this audience about right. And I helped build Carvale.com, and three of the four founders of Chalo, we were at Carvale.com, we also had Bikevale.com. I think what we realized over time building that company was that putting more cars and bikes on road is not our life's dream. And if you die tomorrow morning, that's not the one thing you want to have left behind, that I helped put more cars and bikes on the road. And all of us would have experienced traffic this morning getting here. Is there anyone who didn't experience traffic getting here? That's probably, I can't say that's because of Carvale, but you see, all of us probably came in cars or we took a taxi of some kind, or we took the metro up to a point and then took an auto or took a taxi or something, right? That's the normal behavior I would expect for an audience like this. We are all part of the problem. Let me just say it bluntly. I think that's what I recognized while building Carvale and Bikevale, that in all the cities that we go to around the world, that we admire, like a London, a Hong Kong, a Singapore, etc., the vast majority of people take public transport almost all the time. And I believe in an India where this will be possible in our cities. I believe that we can also have beautiful bus systems, beautiful train systems, beautiful public transport.
Dhruv, that's very interesting. Main interrupt kar rahi hun. I think they know you, they know your work. But my last question to you before we go ahead is, how much you intend to use AI in your current Chalo?
Yeah, so AI and technology in general have not pervaded daily transport at all. We have Uber, we have Ola, we have these other services which rely heavily on technology. But when you think about city buses, the experience is the same as it was 100 years ago. You board a bus, you take out some money, you pay a conductor, they cut a ticket and give it to you, right? Just think about that for a minute. Every other form of our life has been touched, but not this. And we all experience this twice a day, every day. It's almost guaranteed you'll experience it every day of your life, right? So what we do is build technology, and AI has a very important role here. We are already using AI to tell people that as a bus comes down a route towards you, how crowded will it be when it reaches your bus stop? Will you get to sit? Will you have to stand? Will you have to hang outside because it's jam-packed, right? We're already doing that. We're also using the technology to help city administrators using very large-scale ML and layering that up with AI to propose different models. We are helping city administrators and bus operators run better bus services so that their schedules and their fleet can be aligned to where the true demand is.
That's interesting. Thank you, Dhruv. So over to the reticent, quiet guy, Yash. Yash, he's making this app more as what I can say, karmic redemption of Carvale to come towards making it easier for public transport. Aapki journey kaise shuru hui? How did you come up with this?
So I come from the middle class family. I come from the Surat, jahan mera born and brought up hua. तो मेरे घर पे सोलर लगाना था, तो सोलर लगाने के लिए मैं इंजीनियर था, तो मेरे को काम दिया गया कि भाई तू ये टेक्निकल स्पेसिफिकेशन देख. बट जब भी मैंने गूगल किया सोलर लगाने के लिए, तब पता चला कि मैंने टाटा सोलर पैनल्स को गूगल किया. फिर उसमें दो डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स के नंबर मिले, दोनों अलग अलग प्राइस पे टाटा का पैनल ही बेच रहे थे. तो आई गॉट कन्फ्यूज कि ये टाटा का प्राइस मतलब बराबर क्यों नहीं मिल रहा. देन आफ्टर ये सिचुएशन मैंने मेरे नेबर्स के साथ हुए थे भी देखी. सेकेंडली, बीइंग अ इंजीनियर, अंडरस्टैंडिंग द सोलर सिस्टम वॉज अ क्वाइट कॉम्प्लेक्स थिंग, बिकॉज बहुत सारी पैनल्स है, उसकी 25 ईयर्स की लाइफ है, एफिशिएंसी ऑलमोस्ट सिमिलर है, अलग अलग कंपोनेंट है जिसके मैंने कभी नाम भी नहीं सुने, और वो मतलब बहुत कॉम्प्लेक्स हो गया कि मेरा डिसीजन ऐसा बनने लगा कि इससे अच्छा मैं लू ही नहीं. बट मेरे को पता था कि 30% रिटर्न ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट मिल रहा है, गवर्नमेंट सब्सिडी दे रही है, एंड 25 ईयर्स की लाइफ है इसकी. तो लाइक ये चीज़ तो मतलब हम लोगों को लेनी चाहिए और हम लोगों को यूज़ करनी चाहिए, इसका बेनिफिट है. तो लाइक यू नो आई स्टडीड द मार्केट फॉर द 2 ईयर्स ऑन ग्राउंड. मैंने बहुत सारी चीज़ें करी, देखी और समझा कि क्यों ऐसा है. तो देन आफ्टर लाइक यू नो वी कम अप विद द आइडिया कि हम लोग एक एप्लीकेशन बनाते हैं. एप्लीकेशन पे सारी ब्रांड्स होगी, टाटा, अदानी, वारी, जिसको जिसके साथ कंपेयर करना हो टेक्निकली आप कंपेयर भी कर सकते हो, और ऑनलाइन बीडिंग होगी. ऑनलाइन बीडिंग मतलब लाइक आपको टाटा का सोलर पैनल लगाना है, तो जितने भी टाटा के डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स है आपके स्पेसिफिक लोकेशन पे,
Right. Yeah. What you're trying to say, it's an end-to-end solution.
Correct. So you will get the best rate. Like, we ensure about the technicalities and support, and we ensure about, like, you know, you get the QC from us. Like, you know, all
so
the qualities.
So, how are you using AI?
So basically, like, you know, okay, jo preventive maintenance hota hai. Like this panels is coming with a 25 years of warranty. तो कोई प्रॉब्लम आपको होने वाला हो आपके पैनल्स या इन्वर्टर के कोई भी सिस्टम में सो वी आर लाइक यू नो ट्राइंग टू यूटिलाइज दैट डेटा टू प्रिडिक्ट दैट प्रॉब्लम तो हम लोग सर्विस करके वो उसकी लाइफ और बढ़ा दें तो कॉस्ट आपकी घट जाएगी और आपका मतलब लाइफ 10 ईयर बढ़
जाएगा. दैट इज ऑल रोजी सॉरी बट आई हैव अनदर स्पीकर बिफोर आई गो टू हिम. इट कांट बी सच अ ब्यूटिफुल जर्नी कि आपको एक दिन लगा सोलर का ऐप बनना चाहिए डैशबोर्ड बन गया. एनी चैलेंजेस इन दिस जर्नी? एनी चैलेंज?
सो बेसिकली सबसे बड़ा चैलेंज तो यही था कि लाइक यू नो जो डेटा अवेलेबल था वो मतलब सारे चाइनीज एप्लीकेशंस पे है तो डेटा स्क्रैप करना पड़ता है. मतलब लाइक फंडामेंटली एआई के लिए हमको डेटा चाहिए, मतलब डेटा आना चाहिए. तो डेटा जो है वो सारे एपीआईज है वो बैंड है. मतलब अभी इंडिया में इट्स नॉट दैट मच, पीपल आर नॉट अवेयर अबाउट डेटा. सो मोस्ट ऑफ द इन्वर्टर्स पूरी सोलर इंडस्ट्री में जो भी यूज़ हो रहा है वो चाइनीज है तो और वो लोग एपीआई हमको हमारे डेटा के ही नहीं दे रहे. तो लाइक यू नो वी नीड टू स्क्रैप होल सॉर्ट ऑफ डेटा. वी नीड टू लाइक यू नो टेक परमिशंस ऑफ द लाइक या एग्जैक्टली वी नीड टू टेक परमिशन एंड वी नीड टू पुट इट पुट ऑल टुगेदर एंड देन आफ्टर वी लाइक यू नो बिल्ड द मॉडल अपॉन इट. सो दैट वॉज द थिंग कि मतलब लाइक स्टार्टिंग में हमको बहुत सारी हर्डल्स आई. एंड सेकेंडली लाइक यू नो अडेप्टेशन ऑफ द सोलर थिंग, लाइक पीपल अंडरस्टैंडिंग सोलर बट पीपल आर नॉट ट्रस्टिंग सोलर. So that is the challenge that still we are facing. But like, you know, we have completed the journey of 70 gigawatt and our Prime Minister have said like, you know, we need to go 500 gigawatt. So, but like we are very much determined
hopeful
to make a solar
superpower. I'm sure with your kind of sincerity. Dhruv, I believe yours started somewhere in 2014, right? So inko jo early mover advantage hua actually became your disadvantage. So what were your challenges?
Well, I'd say, I think infrastructure is a big challenge. See, if we were starting Chalo in say, London, you could count on the fact that every bus has a GPS. Somebody has already mapped all the routes. Somebody has already done latitude, longitude of every bus stop, figured out how the schedules should work in a city. I think when we started in India, we also thought, ki haan, app bana denge, and people will just use it and do tuk-tuk and realize, okay, I can take a bus, I can take a train. It's when we started the journey is when we realized ki this is not even possible. You have to start at the foundation stone,
true,
which is, you know, nobody knows where the bus stop is. The routes we found were drawn 30 years ago.
Nobody knows
the driver
what's an
is
app
doing
is.
Something different.
Nobody knows what an app is in those days.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. The route that is written on paper, the roads of the city have changed. And the manager says, hamare hisab se to yahi route hai. Ab aap driver se pooch lijiye bus kahan se jaati hai. So, you know, we started with basics in 2014. Like you said, app. When you go to somebody and say, sir, hum app bana rahe hain, they used to be like,
app
yeah, you know, like it's a video game for them. In those days, games were the apps that people use. And they were like, what nonsense, you're wasting my time.
You so know, what is your one message to the startups here for using AI and to flower up?
Yeah, I think in the morning session, you know, we had a speaker very, very clearly say AI is not another tool. AI is an agent. And like AI can be your agent in your individual self, for your companies, I think AI can be a very strong agent of change. And that, I think the advantage when you're building a company, and at least I see that in Chalo, is that it can help at an ecosystem level. And therefore, millions of lives can potentially be improved. That's
awesome. That's interesting. What is your message for everybody?
So basically, like, you know, okay, this adaptation journey going to take time. And basically, this is kind of a thing that like a Microsoft Excel ke jo programs hai, sabko pata nahi hai, but use kar raha. So like this technology should be like, you know, encouraged and like, you know, people should enforce the adaptation slowly, slowly. Then and because we have a huge population and when we come to new technology, when the adaptation came, so we can save millions of rupees by optimizing the power grids and power infra. So please do like, you know, like promote this stuff and use this stuff. It is helping us out. So that's a
thanks a lot. And my message is every audience should be like you, missing lunch to be here. So human in AI loop is very important. A round of applause for the young boys here. Thank you. Thanks a lot.